The assets of suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go frozen by the Court of Appeals. Meanwhile, Senator Sherwin Gachalian reveals a huge portion of Go's money may have come from China. Victoria Thulad now joins us with details. Victoria, what else can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Billions of pesos were allegedly transferred to the various bank accounts of suspended Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go, according to Senator Sherwin Gachalian, who cited reports from the Anti-Money Laundering Council, or AMLAC. In an interview this morning, Gachalian said the amounts were wired from 2019 to 2024, the bulk of which came in from 2019 to 2022. A big portion of this was allegedly traced from China. A document from AMLAC, which was given by Gachalian to the media, says Go has 36 bank accounts. Gachalian explains that there is nothing wrong with having several bank accounts, but one has to be able to explain the transaction. The senator alleged that the flow of money was suspicious because Go could not justify where her money came from. Also questionable was the fact that her corporations were not earning, as supposedly indicated in their income statement. Gachalian says unjustifiable money that came from outside the country is a classic case of money laundering. This is why AMLAC has already filed a case of money laundering against Go and her alleged accomplices before the Court of Appeals on Wednesday, July 10. The court subsequently issued a freeze order on the assets of Go, her business partner and fugitive Wang Ziyang, and Lin Baoying, a Chinese charged of money laundering in Singapore. In a statement, AMLAC said these three individuals are suspected of orchestrating human trafficking and fraudulent activities through the illegal Philippine offshore gaming operators, or POGOs, Zun Yuan and Hong Sheng, and through the Baofulan Development, which are all in Bamban. Meanwhile, Gachalian expects the Senate arrest order versus Mayor Go to be issued today or on Monday. He insisted that the issue on Go's identity has already been settled, especially after a high-ranking official of Grace Christian High School, which is now Grace Christian College in Quezon City, confirmed to his office that the Chinese Go Huaping was their former student from 2000 to 2003. Huaping and Mayor Go are alleged to be the same person. The Senate is still deciding if they will invite an official of the school to the next hearing. Carmina?
Victoria, just a couple of questions for you before we let you go. Let's go back to the flow of money here. Did it emanate from companies, from individuals?
Yes, these came supposedly from individuals and corporations that are based outside of the Philippines, according to reports from AMLAC, which were given to Senator Sherwin Gachalian. Unfortunately, he cannot give us much of information or a lot of details about it because this is still covered under their executive session, Carmina.
And did the senator make any mention of the range of amounts that flowed into the accounts of the mayor?
That was actually asked during the press conference this morning, but he couldn't give it yet because he wanted to confirm the amount that was given to him by the AMLAC. So we are still awaiting that information, Carmina.
All right. Victoria Thulad there joining us on the line. Thanks again. The Philippines marking the 8th anniversary of its landmark arbitral victory against China. But nearly a decade on, Beijing is still rejecting it. On the eve of the anniversary, China published a report saying it neither accepts nor recognizes the award, insisting it will never accept any claim or action arising from the ruling. Back in 2012, China's excessive maritime claims were challenged for the first time by the Aquino administration, taking a giant before the Permanent Court of Arbitration. A ruling in favor of Manila was handed down July 12, 2016, invalidating China's claims. Philippine Senator Risa Ontiveros renewing her call to declare the date as West Philippine Sea Victory Day. She asserts the country needs to show China that Filipinos stand as one in the fight for sovereignty. A consultancy firm playing down the potential impact of a possible POGO ban on the property sector, Lady Vicentro reports.
A ban on Philippine offshore gaming operators is expected to weigh down on the real estate industry. But according to Lee Chu Property Consultants, the impact will be minimal. In its property market update for the first half of 2024, 75,000 square meters of office space, or 10% of the industry share, is occupied by this sector. However, the numbers are already down from 88,000 square meters of office space occupied by POGO in the same period of last year.
If they are completely, they abandon the office completely, of the existing footprint they have, of course that is a large contraction that we will need to will need to find ways to somehow fill up, because they're still quite heavy in terms of the amount of space they have in the market.
Office occupancy by POGO peaked in 2019 and became the largest demand driver for office space. Leach Research and Consultancy Director Roy Goles points out, in terms of residential occupancy, the departure of POGO is seen to affect the Bay Area, Alabang and Makati.
They have vacated the residential condominiums. They will likely also start to, or they have already started selling these residential condominium units. It's a large supply, and if the POGO sector starts to shrink further, then it will negatively impact these locations.
But with POGOs no longer a driver of lease space this year, Baranda said, the industry is now in a balanced position as demand in the ITBPM, traditional offices and government offices, has picked up. Office demand in the first half of 2024 is up by 24% compared to 2023 on the back of increase in leasing activity in these sectors.
We've seen some growth, but not the same growth as we've experienced in 2019. So they're similar to any other business now. If they need to grow, they take space. Unlike before, where they were taking space speculatively, meaning they will lease an entire building and then find a way to fill up.
Meanwhile, the residential market remains upbeat as sales are up by 6.5% for the second quarter of 2024 after a decline in the past three quarters. Despite granted residential estate loans slipping by 9% during the first quarter, it rose by 2% outside Metro Manila. The company projects robust residential demand outside Metro Manila, driven by infrastructure projects such as the new Manila International Airport and expressways leading to the south. For hotel, tourism and leisure, Bohol emerged as the most preferred destination for hotel investments with its steady increase of foreign tourist arrivals. Metro Manila, Cebu City, Siargao and El Nido were also cited as preferred investment locations for tourism. With the Banco Central ng Pilipinas signaling for rate cuts within the year, the firm is optimistic that the move will strengthen developer and investment activities in the industry. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.